Hello and welcome to our channel. Today we'll be diving into the topic of NAS and SAN to understand the key differences between these storage solutions. So, let's get started. First, let's talk about NAS. NAS stands for Network Attached Storage. If you're looking for a centralized storage location that can be accessed from all devices on your network, a NAS device is what you need. Essentially, a NAS is a dedicated storage device that focuses solely on data storage. Typically, a NAS comes in the form of a box with multiple hard drives configured in a RAID setup for redundancy. It also has a network interface card that directly connects to a switch or router, enabling data access over the network. Once connected, other devices such as desktops, laptops, and servers can access the NAS as a shared drive. NAS devices find their applications in homes, small to medium-sized businesses, and other similar environments. NAS, or Network Attached Storage, operates independently of the local area network LAN and instead utilizes a high-speed fiber channel network in NAS. Data identification involves both the file name and byte offset. Moreover, NAS is generally more cost-effective compared to SAN storage area network. It finds significant application in backup and recovery processes as it allows for easy file-level access and management. Now let's shift our focus to SAN, which stands for Storage Area Network. The SAN is a dedicated, high-speed network designed to store and provide access to large amounts of data. SAN consists of multiple disk arrays, switches, and servers, all interconnected within this special network. This fault-tolerant setup ensures that even if one of these components fails, data can still be accessed. When a server accesses data on a SAN, it recognizes it as a local hard drive rather than a shared network drive, making it seamless for operating systems. SAN, or Storage Area Network, can be difficult to manage due to the need for additional administration. Setting up and maintaining a SAN environment often involves complex configurations and meticulous monitoring. Moreover, SAN relies on fiber channel technology for connecting multiple data storage devices, which can be both expensive and cumbersome to implement. Additionally, the file system in SAN is usually managed and controlled by servers, adding another layer of complexity and potential. Points of failure. Fiber channel provides extremely fast speeds, ranging from 2 gigabits per second up to a staggering 128 gigabits per second. Although fiber channel is expensive, it delivers the required performance for most SAN setups. Alternatively, some SANs use ISCSI as a cheaper alternative, although it's not as fast as fiber channel. SAN relies on the local area network and requires the use of the TCP/IP network protocol. Data in SAN is identified using disk blocks, and it tends to be more expensive than NAS. SAN employs a block-by-block technique for backup and recovery operations, making it suitable for large-scale enterprise environments that demand high performance and reliability. In summary, NAS and SAN offer different approaches to data storage. NAS is ideal for centralized storage accessible over a network, while SAN provides a dedicated high-speed network with fault tolerance and scalability. While NAS finds its place in homes and small to medium-sized businesses, SANs are predominantly used by larger organizations due to their cost and advanced capabilities. That concludes our discussion on NAS and SAN. We hope this video has clarified the differences between the two. If you found it helpful, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.